Well, hello there, collectors. It is Steven here, and welcome back to another Rampage review. Continuing to look at the movie stuff, we got done looking at the Canister Contact Ralph set, so now we're moving on to the Big City Brawl Ralph set. Yeah, so as some of you may or may not be aware, Ralph and the others do change throughout the movie, as you would expect by the Rampage storyline, even throughout the games, and this is the depiction of Ralph as he is later on in the movie. Now, bigger figure, bigger price point, better figure? Who knows? So let's take a look to see whether or not it's worth adding into your collection. Before we formally get this review started, here is a look at the box for the Big City Brawl Ralph. And as you can see here, there's a nice window display where you can see Ralph and all of the goodies that he might come with. On the back of the box, we just have some more promotional stuff, so this way you can see what the prototype looked like, some promotional blurbs, the action features, and a short synopsis of the movie. If you're interested in reading this, it's the same across all of the figures. You can go ahead and click on pause now and read that, because you can do that, all right? All right. First and foremost, just like we did with Lizzie, we're going to take a look at all of the stuff that Ralph comes with first, and then we'll move on to Ralph, because Ralph is lighter on accessories to make up for the larger figure. So first and foremost, the army dude that we get with Ralph here is pretty straightforward, pretty basic. We have some very nice detailing for the size and for the price, but he is pre-posed and articulation is kind of limited. So if you're a fan of some of these generic G.I. Joe or not G.I. Joe-like characters, then this is going to be one you're definitely going to want to add to your shelf, because he does come with two guns already attached to his hands that you can remove if you pop the bands off, but I'm not going to do that because that upset some people in my Kong Skull Island reviews, and I just want to continue doing that. I am spiteful like that. So for articulation, we're just pretty much looking at some basic swivels, as you can clearly see here. Not much more than that. So if you're thinking you maybe want to get them into a different pose like you're going to be able to with the Rock figures that George comes with, some of the George figures anyway, that's not going to happen. Now, Ralph actually comes with one neat diorama piece, and that is a piece of a bus. Yeah, so this is really cool. This is one of those accessories that I think can be used even beyond Ralph here, because as you're actually going to see in the end shot, if you're really good at action figure photography, then this is one that you can use to stage shots. So this is going to be coming back in the future for a couple of pictures. So the detailing on this is actually really cool. It looks like it's molded in an all-blue plastic, and we have black and silver paint apps, not only for the actual characteristics of the bus, like the tire and the window, but also to show the damage, which is really neat. Unfortunately, there's no real decoration on the inside of the bus, which would be the back of it, so take it or leave it there for those of you who really want detailing, but there's one really cool feature of the bus. This panel here actually pops off. Yeah, that was really cool. It scared me because I thought it actually broke. You know, a broken bus is broken further. But still, what's also neat about this is you can actually have your different kaiju figures chomp on it, because there are teeth marks on that spot. How cool is that? So that is actually a nice segue into talking about Ralph himself. Now talking about Ralph here, I have to say that obviously, it's a bigger figure. Obviously, we're going to have different sculpt and paint apps. But what I gotta say here is that while I am more impressed with Ralph here, I got a quality control dud. Yeah, of course, Steven got a dud. What else is new? But aside from that, he actually does look very, very nice with nice paint shading. He actually does look kind of scaly, which I attribute more to the design than Lennard's doing. But one thing I'm kind of upset with here is that, as you saw on the box earlier, I guess Ralph at some point was supposed to be a silverish blue color, and didn't carry over into the movie design or the product, so yeah, I'm a bit upset with that. But anyway, regardless of that, as you can see, Ralph does look very intimidating for a wolf, and let's take a closer look. Up close and personal at the head, you can see that, if I have to be really critical here, which I'm gonna be because I think that I can be here and you'll see why, the teeth and the eyes are very shiny and not, I guess you could say, in sync with the rest of the paint. They kind of stand out and they don't really look natural. They sort of seem cheaper in quality than the rest of the figure, because the rest of the figure has very, very smooth transitions with paint, fantastic blending even at this price point, but not necessarily at the teeth and the eyes. However, that being said, that doesn't mean that they're bad. It just means that I don't think that it really flows with the rest of the figure. But beyond that, we do have an interesting looking nose, and we do have cleanly painted ears, which is great to see. And as we move on through the rest of the figure, we can see great paint blending on the neck, underneath by his throat. It looks fantastic. There's no overspraying there. As we move up to the back of Ralph, where you will see that one of the back spikes on mine was broken. And as we zoom in here on the packaging shots, you can see that actually happened in package. That wasn't my doing. Yeah, that's unfortunate. As we move on down to the spoiler kids, if you didn't watch any of the trailers, the webbing for where his wings might be, we can see that the paint is nice and crisp there. Overall, Ralph really does look fantastic. There really isn't much to be upset about. And if you really do appreciate paint apps, and if you really want to see a good example of paint and you collect the SH Monster Arts line, this is a pretty good example. Ralph's articulation is pretty straightforward and simple. He does have an action feature where if you move his neck, his mouth does open and close. He does have swivels at where the legs connect into the body. And on the front two legs, he does have hinges at the elbows and at the ankles. Unfortunately, no ankle rocker movements. On the back two legs, it does look like there are cuts for swivels, but unfortunately, there's nothing there. They are glued. And the tail does have a hinge, so it kind of moves in and out. Now, mine has a quality control issue where the top part of the head likes to slide off, so good job, Leonard. Now, here is just a comparison with the canister contact Ralph, so this way you can see where the clear differences are, not only between size, but in the sculpting from the two different versions of Ralph that we may see in the movie, because again, the movie isn't out, I haven't seen it. Or have I? Yeah, so here's what you can probably expect to see maybe on the big screen, and the differences that you may want to have represented in your collection. And to round off the review, here is a size comparison with the other Big City Brawl figures, Lizzie in the back, just like I mentioned in my Lizzie review, and some other kaiju figures you're going to have. These figures are definitely large, and I don't think they really blend in well with a 6-inch scale display. However, for the, I guess you might say, iconic versions of the kaiju we will see in the movie, these are going to be the only figures that you're going to have the option of getting in something that's close to 6-inch scale. So, you be the judge on whether or not you'd like these. So, buy now, skip, or wait for a deal. Ralph overall does look very nice, but I did get a quality control dud with a broken back spike and the top portion of the mouth that likes to fall off. However, that bust is really, really cool, and it makes for a fantastic diorama display piece, even at any scale, especially if you know how to work a camera. So, all in all, I have to say for around $15, your price may vary because you may have to have a buddy send it to you, or you're going to have to buy it online because you live in a different country, whatever it may be. For the MSRP of about $15, this is a pretty solid set. Nothing over the top, and Ralph may make for a great steed for some of your other figures. Just don't go into this expecting, let's say, Bandai America or even NECA quality of an action figure. You're going to get something that has a couple of action features and looks pretty nice. But beyond that, keep your expectations in check. Well, folks, that's the end of this review. Thanks for watching, and be sure to follow me on social media to catch more behind-the-scenes shenanigans and updates. The end card should be popping up now with more hand-selected SDR goodness for you to watch, so check out some of those videos. Be sure to check the description, too, to see where you can buy this figure or others like it and some cool links like the credits for this video and other ways you can help out the channel. Thanks again for watching, and I'll catch ya in the next video.